We are here, we are here, we are here on this amazing day. Okay, everyone, this is Cam Jones, FX Daily Analysis, and we are marking up GBP USD. We are on a monthly time frame. Price action, last candle to right hand side, is a bullish green candle. We do have price action overall, lower lows. Price action overall, higher highs. Midpoint. Also adding second level lows. And also adding third level lows. So let's zoom in the price and see what's going on. So monthly time frame, GBP USD sitting as a bullish green candle. Price is currently at 1.15610. And if price work is way up, it can head to the middle of that resistance and support. Touch that midline for at a price of 1.18087. And if price work is way down and head down to the midpoint of the resistance we just created and the support, you can head down to numbers of 1.13414, and we can see price action in the middle of that area. Price action candle, bullish green candle, looks something close to a doji until we start seeing that what that market is really going to do. So if that market is going to go up, we're looking for that market to tag the bottom as it currently did, and price action to engulf the second last candle, if not have to wait for the second candle to form, or the next candle to form after the current price action candle, could draw that market up for that third leg. Then we're looking for the retest or in that fourth leg double bottom for that market to work it up way up to second level lows. If not, that market can't consolidate as it currently doing. Price action is within the second last candle. Price action body is not above the previous body. Price action wick is not above the previous wick, so it's having a hard time breaking up to that next level. So as we walk down the time frame, we're going to see what's going on. And if that market doesn't work its way sideways for that consolidation, it can also push down to another level. If so, we'll be identifying that market coming from an area of multiple pushes to that top of that first leg, overall second, third, fourth. So we have a double top, and the market could come back up to the midpoint, already tagging near that area until we receive a engulfing pattern towards the price action second last candle to push that market down to the price number of 1.0555. Working our way to the weekly time frame. Price action on the weekly time frame identifying as a bullish green doji. Looks something like a doji. You have a bit of a wick to the upside, but a little bit longer wick to the downside. So that market is tagging the area support and trying to push up from the previous area. So price action already tagged that midpoint of that area. So we have a midpoint overall highs, price action overall lower lows of that area. So market, what it identified as a break, the retest, and pushed up. So if that market works its way down, we'll see the break, the retest, the market pushes down. If not, we'll see that market break into that area. So it's patterns inside of patterns. Below price, we do have a double bottom of that first, second, third, fourth, second last candle retest, price action pushing and breaking out. So we're looking for that push, identifying the retest for that market to push up from a double bottom and retest. Now, if not, that market can't consolidate sideways within that area. Working our way to down to the daily time frame. Price action on the daily time frame is identifying as a bullish green doji, so it's trying to come back to retest. Second last candle lost momentum from that third last candle push. So if that market works its way up, we can see that staircase pattern with that incline. We have that first, second, third, fourth retest, market push once, retesting the previous side at that midpoint to see if that market's going to engulf the price second and third to work is that way up for another push. If not, Mark is running two multiple tags to that area, which will be identified the break the retest. So that's the first leg, overall second, third. If we receive the engulfment to price action to the third to last candle, Mark is coming down from that double top in that area. So we can see that that market is in a wedge pattern. So if we connect the support to the top side, we can see that market headed down. It can head down and tag that trend line. If not, break that trend. If it breaks a trend line, it's going through that support. And if we look at connecting the resistance horizontally, we can see that market bouncing up and down. So we're going to see that market going to break out of that resistance. If not, market's coming down, headed down to the 4-hour time frame. Price action on the 4-hour time frame identifying as a bullish green candle tag that resistance or that midpoint of that area. So let's draw the screen out just a little bit. So we have price action high, we have that midpoint, and we have that low. We can see the market consolidating at that midpoint, so we can see that pattern that's trying to form. So we're looking for the breakout towards the last few candles in the market, which is in that cluster. So we're looking for the breakout of this area here. So market just broke out of that zone just a bit. So we're waiting for a pattern to form. So it's either going to break, overall retest that area, and we start seeing that market pushes up. Always identify that market's coming down from an area of a double top in there. So we have incline double top, first, second, third, fourth. We have a bearish red doji, came back to retest, market push once, retest, market push twice, retest. If market push and breaks out of that, that'll be a third push. And well, that market can consolidate within that zone until we finally receive that pattern for that market to break out. Walking down to the 3-minute time frame. 3-hour time frame, price action, 3-hour time frame identifying a bullish green doji. So market is coming from that area that multiple pushes to that top. First, second, third, fourth, retest, market push down. So there's a triple top in this area, a double top and a retest, or a head and shoulders pattern. And then market did a double retest below that triple top. And if it doesn't break out, we see it again, which if we receive the engulfment to the downside, price second, third, market's working its way down. Headed down to the 2. Price action on the 2 is a bullish green candle, trying to work its way back up. But the thing is right now is that price action is identifying as tagging that second last, that midpoint of that area. But we can see that that second last candle came back for a retest, and that price action having a hard time breaking above that with that wick. So price action wick is not too far above that previous one. So as we walk down the market, we're going to see what's happening. So we look for that price to head back to that zone to identify a pattern that the market's going to break out. If not, we can receive that rejection in that area, which will identify the break, the retest, and the market's coming back down. Headed down to the 1-hour time frame. Price action bullish green candle. So now we're already seeing that while with that previous candle price action 2-hour time frame, that's why it looks like that. It's because we have that first, second, second last candle is a retest for that third leg, and price is trying to break out. Price is above the previous candles, tag that zone. Now as we walk down the time frame, we're looking to see what that market is going to happen at that zone. Price action still having a hard time breaking out that second last candle. So what you're waiting for is price action to head to that midpoint to identify the break, or is it coming back down and be rejected from that area? 30-minute time frame, same as well. We see that full break, retest one. And it's retest the second time. Now he's going to break out and create that W formation. If not, it's tagging that area to work his way down. 15-minute time frame, consolidating, tag, retest, and trying to push and break out with that 15-minute. 5-minute time frame. Now we can see why, because we got to see that W incline, W first, second, third, fourth. See, waiting for the breakout. Headed down to a 3-minute time frame, same as well. Headed down to the 1-minute time frame, see markets coming to create that second level lows pattern of that triple bottom. Okay, guys, GBP, USD.